European market chair for December the 21st, 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. And I remind you, the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not alert service. I'm not going to make any direct trade recommendations during the course of a day, but what I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis. With a bit of luck at all, we can put together some decently profitable trade plans. Please keep in mind, trading heavily leveraged is risky business, particularly when you're leveraged 50 to 1, sometimes more. Occasionally, this leverage will work for you. Unfortunately, as a novice, you know it'll also work against you. So please do not trade your hard-earned money until you have a track record of success using your broker's demo. All right, guys. Well, let's just continue with our pound analysis. All right. You know, it's late in the year. The markets are thin. It's very much a take what you can get and step aside sort of trading right now. So, you know, here's cable. If I show you the weekly very quickly. You know, this is very much what I'm expecting. If I take a fib of the whole rise, okay, you'll notice that we are sitting directly at a 382 Fibonacci retracement right now, but we've bounced off this already. All right, so, you know, we've come off it once already, made the lower high. Now I'm thinking, right, off the 382, make a lower high, head down to the 50%, and then we'll probably fib the whole rise. All right, before, I think, continuing for further downside come the new year. But nonetheless, you know, this downside price action here to the 50% is ultimately what we're trying to capture, aren't we? All right, so, you know, that's all I'm really trying to position for on the pound at the moment. Okay, so now that's easier said than done. You know, I mean, if you short somewhere around, I don't know, 158 or something, you know, and you're in decent shape. If you're just trying to get short, it's a little more challenging going to the daily chart, because ultimately, here's what I'm trying to negotiate. Okay, to me, this now is all short zone, right? You know, if we were to head up to say 56.5 today, if not sort of 57, that to me is a good spot just to sort of head up there and continue down to the short side. All right, I'm just not certain that you're gonna make it up there. All right, I think if I show you the 4 hour very quickly, as long as you're making lower highs, you gotta be bearish here, guys. You know, and there's no question that we are still making lower highs. Look, right, lower high, lower high, lower high. So as long as you're making these lower highs, granted, you're making higher lows, it's got very little to do with it. All right, some people are going to be trying to see this as a double bottom. I think you're a little bit stretched there. But as long as we're making these lower highs, I think you've got to be bearish, you know, and then this will start to look like just a continuation sort of trap for further downsides. That's ultimately what I'm looking for. I'd like to look for a short around 55-40 area, and you know, around sort of, if I grab a fib of yesterday's drop, all right, just zooming in here, how about we go to an hourly, make this a little clearer. All right, if we just take a fib now of this swing drop on the hourly, you know, basically I'm looking for shorts back in the same spot. I'm looking for shorts here back in the same spot as where it got, you know, where it fibbed short again today, and that's around 55-30. You know, that's what I'm saying. Look, if we look for a short in this zone, all right, that gives us a very limited risk sort of trade, right? We can look for a short around sort of 30 to 45 area, and really with a stop, I don't think we need a stop much more above say 53 here. All right, so risking about 25 sort of pips here to get, you know, I think we could very easily make our way down to 154. All right, if this thing works, if there's enough money in the market to push us, 154 looks very achievable, if not 54.5. So therefore, risking about 25 to get, you know, better part of 100 and change, all right, which isn't bad. Now, if we break that 40 zone, then I think that cable is long, and probably long to a fib of the last major daily swing drop. And let me show you that. All right. You know, so here's your daily, and if we break this 40 zone, 55-40, then I think that pound is on its way up here to around 56-30. All right, so if we break that, we'll be doing a little something like this before then continuing to the downside. But, you know, I'm willing to trade in the direction of my bias first and even lose money doing that, as silly as that sounds. And, you know, until it proves me wrong. All right, and then I'll look to take the other side of it, because I'm a pound bear. I want to remain a pound bear. We're coming off a lower high, so I'm looking to take the shorts off resistance as much as possible, really, until the trend changes against me. All right, so there's your pound outlook today. Pretty simple stuff. I mean, we got another thing. you got 56.32, which is actually the weekly central pivot today too. So if we break, you know, if we break 55.40 area, you're gonna target that weekly central in here. All right, but ultimately that's where I'm looking to get short from, is around that 55.40, 55.35 area with really a pretty tight stop, because if we break that, then I think we are hitting up 100 pips. So, you know, then I also, you know, then I obviously want to flip my position. All right, so I'm not sure there will be any more videos before Christmas. So let me wish everybody a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. If you don't celebrate Christmas, take some time off and enjoy yourselves a little bit. You know, this is not the time of year to be playing catch up. It really isn't. You know, this week and next are really, really thin in the market. It's time to sort of consolidate your year a little bit, take things easy. I'm trading a third of my normal lot size just to try and mitigate as much risk as I can. And if we can make daily bread, great. And if we can't, fine. You know, I'll see you in January. All right, so there we have it, folks. All the best, and we'll chat to you guys in a couple of days. Take care.